Injections aren't anybody's favourite healthcare intervention. BioLingus, a Swiss biotech firm, has developed a technology that can stabilise different molecules for sublingual delivery, a simple tablet that goes under the tongue. With me is BioLingus CEO Yves Decadt. Yves, tell me about the technology you've developed and the new kinds of treatments that it enables for sublingual delivery.
Sublingual delivery on itself is not new. It has been used in industry for small molecules, organic molecules. What is new is that we have redeveloped it for biological molecules, and that is new. And biological molecules typically have to be injected because biological molecules are degrading in the body. So we, our technology enables to deliver these biological molecules sublingually in a pill. So what we're working on is mainly treatments in diabetes on one hand and inflammatory diseases. Because these are most suitable.
So what is it about the biological component that makes it hard to deliver? And tell me about the seed technology, because this is what enables this.
Yeah, that's indeed, that goes to the essence of the technology, actually. Human body is, let's say, designed by nature to degrade meat. Meat consists of proteins and peptides, exactly the constituents of what we call biological medicines. So if you take these biological medicines, they will be degraded completely in the body. And so we have looked in nature again, if we could find other places where nature has stabilized these molecules. And we have found that in the seed of plants. So we have taken these lessons from nature, bioengineered that, and now we are able to stabilize such molecules for a very long time. And that's the basis of our technology, actually.
What are the benefits of sublingual delivery compared with injections?
Yeah, first of all, if you take it orally, well, it's much more convenient. It's also more low cost in a certain way, and that's where governments, let's say, with pressure on healthcare budgets also are looking at. The other thing is that if you have molecules that work on the immune system, then sublingual delivery is also very good because it brings these molecules into the lymphatic system. And the lymphatic system is the heart of the immune system. And so there it's not just about convenience, we can actually increase the efficacy of these molecules. So we're working on one specific molecule, which is called interleukin 2. And there we have shown in an allergy model that we can increase the efficacy almost 500 times. So we may reduce the dose substantially. And if you can reduce the dose, of course, you reduce the cost, but you may also reduce the side effects.
Tell me more about the cost effectiveness, because it isn't just in the delivery system itself, but the infrastructure that needs to be built around injectable treatments.
Yeah, that's correct. And that's a kind of different application that we have been coming up for emerging countries. Problem in these countries is that they need a cold chain because they're biological drugs. You need to refrigerate them up to the patient, which is costly and difficult in these countries. Our technology, in essence, is a stabilizing technology. And as a result of that, you may not need the cold chain. Secondly, there are a lot of infections due to the use of needles. And with our technology, we can also prevent these infections due to injections. For instance, HIV, HCV, and so on. So very serious infections, actually. And thirdly, our technology is really a high-tech approach, but it is essentially low-cost, which is also important for, let's say, the payers in those countries. So we just have been understanding that our technology is extremely well suited for those countries, yeah, although it was not our original intention.
So finally, what does the future of BioLingus look like? What's next in your project pipeline? What are you hoping to achieve in the next three, four, 5 years?
As a company, we want to develop in, let's say, different ways. We will combine different types of innovation. So incremental innovation, disruptive innovation, and then social innovation. So these are the three pillars we want to build the company on. And just to give an example, in incremental innovation, we are developing an oral version of exenatide, which is a diabetes drug. We're also working on oral version of cannabis extracts. So this is incremental innovation. It's switching the injectable to an oral version. And then we are also working on some projects that are really disruptive. One example is in diabetes type 1. Diabetes type 1 is an autoimmune disease, actually. So the immune system attacks your own body in this case. So if we give a certain molecule called interleukin 2, we can actually delay the onset of diabetes type 1 in children. And of course, children don't like injections. So that's really disruptive. And then coming to the social innovation, one project we work on is on leishmaniasis. And leishmaniasis is actually a neglected tropical disease. It's neglected because economics don't work very well. But we want to work on it. We want to make an oral vaccine for leishmaniasis because, again, we think our technology would be very appropriate for that. So we combine these different types of innovation. We're very excited about that, and we believe we can make a small change in a big world.
Yves, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
You can find out more about BioLingus technology at europeanceo.com. And please subscribe for the latest business, finance, and strategic insights transforming Europe.